भाई ये है, आप सभी जानते हैं हम लोग एक बहुत बड़े पेंडेमिक से गुजर रहे हैं और बहुत सारे ऐसे बच्चे हैं जो क्लासरूम्स अटेंड नहीं कर पा रहे हैं और वे लोग अपने अपने स्टडी से डिप्राइव हो रहे हैं। सो मैंने सोचा कि मैं मेरे पास जो कुछ भी एक्सपीरियंस है इतने दिन का, उसको मैं बच्चों को हेल्प करने के लिए यूज़ करूँ। और फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद चैप्टर ऑफ ग्रामर, द वेरी इनिशियल चैप्टर, पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच। वन बाई वन वी शैल डिस्कस द अदर टॉपिक्स ऑल्सो, एंड इफ यू फेस एनी काइंड ऑफ डिफिकल्टी यू कैन सेंड मी मैसेज एंड आई विल ट्राई टू इम्प्रूव इट। What language you are comfortable, please let me know. If you want to do the classes in Hindi, I will continue maximum in Hindi. And if you want to do in English, then I will continue the same. Parts of a speech is the first chapter of grammar. You all know there are 8 parts of a speech: noun, pronoun, adjective, verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction, and interjection. We discuss one by one all these chapters. You all know that what is noun? Noun is a naming word. The word noun is what? The name of a particular place, person or thing. So, any word which has its name, particular name, is called noun. There are 5 types of noun: proper noun, common noun, collective noun, material noun, and abstract noun. We shall discuss it one by one. What is pronoun? Pronoun is a huge chapter. Today I will discuss only about noun, because to understand noun properly will help us in other chapters of the grammar ahead. Noun is a naming word. You know there are 5 kinds of noun. Proper noun. What is proper noun? Proper noun, that means a particular name. Maybe the name of a country, maybe the name of a person, maybe the name of an epic or whatever. Common noun is a noun which includes everything which we see commonly as a flower. Flower, that means the all types of flower. Maybe rose, maybe jasmine, maybe lily, maybe lotus or whatever. All types of flower. When we say flower, then it is a common noun. When you say lotus, rose, marigold, jasmine, then it becomes a proper noun. Collective noun. What is collective noun? Collective noun is a group or a collection. Suppose when we say army, army is a common noun. But when we say a troop of army, then it is collective noun. When we say students, all the students are common noun. But when we say a particular, the students of class 9, students of class 12, then it becomes what? Collective noun. And what is material noun? Any form, liquid or solid, suppose iron, metal, these are called what? Material noun. And abstract noun. What is abstract noun? Abstract noun is the noun which we cannot see or touch. We can feel the kindness of mother. The kindness is the word which we can't connect. Kindness we can't touch, we can't see, but we can feel very well that this is a very affectionate feeling of our heart. So we can say these types of feelings are abstract noun. There are many types of common noun. We have discussed common noun. What is common noun? The name, the cat, that means all the cats is common noun. But when we say that this is the cat, then it becomes particular. So common noun has a huge chapter. There are concrete noun. Suppose chair, table, tree, or a particular animal is called concrete noun. Concrete noun is the noun which we can see clearly. Uncountable noun and countable noun. You know countable, what is countable noun? The noun, the things which we can count precisely is called countable noun. And the things which we can't count is called uncountable noun, as milk, sand, etc. Singular noun. What is singular and plural noun? You know one thing is called singular and more than one is plural. This is very simple to know. This is very simple to identify. But when we are going to make a singular to a plural noun, there are so many rules to make, because English is very as tense type of language, and there are so many kinds of words which we can't classify in a particular rule. So we have to know so many rules, so many things to understand how to make singular from plural. And another one is collective noun. I have discussed collective noun, that is a group or a troop. And another one is gender. What is gender? There are four types of gender. You know, you all know there are four types of gender: masculine, feminine, common, and neutral. We shall discuss. You know, you absolutely know that what is masculine gender. You know, जो चीज हमको एक मेल के बारे में पुरुष के बारे में बताती है उसको मैस्कुलिन जेंडर कहते हैं. द थिंग्स विच रेफर्स टू फीमेल जेंडर, दैट मीन्स स्त्रीवाचक संज्ञा जो होता है उसको हम क्या कहते हैं, फीमेल जेंडर कहते हैं. कॉमन, जिसमें लेडीज भी है और जेंट्स भी है, जैसे पेरेंट्स माँ फीमेल जेंडर, फादर मैस्कुलिन जेंडर, तो दोनों मिलकर के क्या हुए, कॉमन जेंडर, दैट इज पेरेंट्स. टीचर्स, देर आर मेल टीचर्स एंड फीमेल टीचर्स, सर्स एंड मैडम्स आर देयर, सो टीचर्स आर व्हाट, कॉमन जेंडर. स्टूडेंट्स, देर आर मेल स्टूडेंट्स एंड फीमेल स्टूडेंट्स, गर्ल्स स्टूडेंट्स एंड बॉयज स्टूडेंट्स, सो वी कैन से दिस इज कॉमन जेंडर. एंड न्यूट्रल जेंडर, न्यूट्रल देन स्मॉल इंसेक्ट्स, स्मॉल एनिमल्स और द थिंग्स विच आर विच इज लाइफलेस इज कॉल्ड न्यूट्रल जेंडर. Abstract noun. What is abstract noun? I have already described it, that the things which we can't see or can't touch is called abstract noun. These are the forms of noun, and there are so many things to understand in this chapter also. Now we shall discuss some common mistakes we used to do, the silly mistakes. When we going to face a competition, the question setters used to put some silly mistakes which we generally slip to understand, and then there is a chance to make our mistakes. The first one is that two female walk in. This is a wrong sentence because we can't use two females. We have to say two women walked in. Another one is, he is my cousin brother. This is so humorous. My cousin brother. Because he himself is a masculine pronoun, and he himself stands for a brother or masculine gender. So we have not to mention cousin brother. We can simply say he is my cousin. The third one is that I attended a marriage yesterday. This is also a wrong sentence because we can't say attended a marriage. We have to say I attended a wedding yesterday. The last sentence is Sheila is learning a new poetry. All you know, poetry, what is the difference between poetry and poem? Poem is a singular, a particular piece of writing, and poetry is a huge collection of poems. So how can Sheila learn the whole poetry at the same time? So this sentence is obviously wrong. There should be Sheila is learning a new poem. Bacho, हमारे पास अभी वीडियो क्वालिटी अच्छा नहीं है. हम बहुत सारे डिफिकल्टीज फेस करके जस्ट स्टार्ट किए हैं किसी भी तरह से. दिस इज माय फर्स्ट वीडियो, यू नो, सो आई शैल ट्राई टू इम्प्रूव. एंड दिस इज अ न्यू एक्सपीरियंस ऑल्सो, सो आई फील वेरी अनकम्फर्टेबल. इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो आई शैल ट्राई टू बी मोर कम्फर्टेबल विथ यू, एंड आई विल रिक्वेस्ट यू हम्बली सो मेनी टाइम्स दैट प्लीज लाइक, शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल. एंड इफ योर सजेशन, ऑलवेज आई वेलकम योर सजेशन to improve my next classes. Thank you.